Hello students, today we will start video number 2, class 9, chapter 1, number system. So in first video, we will discuss about introduction of number system and some key points. Now today we will start our first topic is how we can check whether the given number are rational or not, means rational or irrational number. So how we can check a given number? There are some given numbers. Suppose let's take an example. If 7 minus 2 root 5 plus 2 root 5, so it is a number. So how we can check it is a rational or irrational? Root 5 and root 5 are irrational. But this is not your complete solution. After solve this question, the answer becomes, then we can check it is a rational or irrational. So how we can solve this? 7 minus 2 root 5 plus 2 root 5. Minus 2 root 5 plus 2 root 5 cancel it. The answer becomes 7. 7 means 7 upon 1. It is in the form of P by Q. It is in the form of P upon Q. So it is in rational form. So it is in rational form. Okay, the next one is 0. Take another example like 0. We can write 0 in the form of 0 upon 1. So 0 upon becomes 0, means 0 upon 1 in the form of P by Q. So yes, it is also in rational form. Okay, next check, suppose C part, 5.01289689896896 dot dot. This is your third part. Check this, the decimal number is not terminating or repeating, it is an repeating form, because 896 896 896 repeat after the decimal or many of times. 896 896 896 means ye repeat ho raha hai, there are many of times. Okay, so repeating form is not a rational form, it is irrational form. Okay, so these are the three examples how we can check the given number is a rational form or irrational form. The remaining parts you can do in your from your book, textbook. Okay. The next topic is topic number 2. Rational numbers as division of integers. Suppose we know that the form P upon Q represent the division of integer P by integer Q, means P by Q jo form hai represent karta hai ki P divided by Q. But solving the division, we can find the decimal of the decimal number. How we can find the decimal of the by the long division method? Let's take an example. A part, 5 by 8, this form is a rational form, means P by Q. And how we can convert into decimal form? By division of 8 divided by 5. Yes, 5 is a smaller number, so 0.50 ho gaya. 6 8 is 48, remainder becomes 2, 0, 2 is 16, 4, 0, 5 is 40, the remainder becomes 0. So what is the decimal form? The decimal form is 0.625. So This is the second topic, rational number. How we can convert rational number as a division of integer. I take another example. 4 divided by 3. 4 ones are 1, decimal 0, 3 is a 9, 1, 0, 3 is a 9, 1 means the answer becomes 1.33333, means 4 by 3 is equal to 1.3333, means 1.3 bar. So it is a repeating form. So if it is a repeating form, means it is a okay. So these are the examples of rational number how you can convert into integer form. The next topic is observing the decimal expansion of a rational number, means how we can convert decimal form into a rational form. There are two cases. Case number one, when the remainder is zero. When the remainder is zero, in this case, the remainder becomes in the case the remainder becomes 0 and the quotient or decimal expansion terminates after a finite numbers of digit after the decimal points, means if we divide a number, the answer becomes in a decimal form, but after decimal form there are digits are finites, then we can say that it is a terminating form. Let's take an example. 5 by 8, we get remainder 0. Now check it, 0.0648, answer becomes 2, 0, 8, 2 is 16, answer becomes 4, 8, 5 is 40. The remainder becomes 0, but the quotient is 0.625. The remainder as 0 and the quotient as 0.625. Okay, so after decimal there are only 3 digits, means it is in finite form. So first part, when the remainder becomes 0, so how we can solve this? It is in also rational form and it is a decimal form. Case number 2, when the remainder is never 0. Let's take an example. 4 divided by 3. 3 ones are 3. 1.0333 is 9, again 1, 0, 3, 3 is 9, again 1, 0, means the remainder is not comes to 0. In this case, the remainder never come zero and and the corresponding decimal expansion is non-terminating. Means if after decimal the digits are finite, means it is in terminating form, and after decimal the digit are not in finite form, means it comes in number of terms repeating form, so it is a non-terminating. Okay, it is a non-terminating decimal. Let's take an no need to another example. If you want to solve yourself, let I am giving you one question. 2/7. Okay, so this is the topic of observing the decimal expansion of a rational form. Means if a rational number is given, how we can check it is a terminating or non-terminating? Means after decimal, after divide, the quotient is in decimal form, and after decimal the digits are repeating form, means it is a non-terminating. After decimal the digits are not repeating form, means in a finite forms, means it is a terminating form. Okay, so first part, second part 65/101, third part 923/400, it's your homework. 37/99, and fifth part 67/100. So these are the questions, and find the answer is in terminating form or non-terminating form. So this is your third topic, observing the decimal expansion of a rational number. The next topic is converting a terminating decimal into a fraction form. So how we can convert decimal terminating decimal into fraction form? Let suppose one question is given, express the number 2.25 in the form of p/q. Here the value of x is 2.25. There are two digit after the decimal form. There are two digit after the decimal form. We can write x equal to 225/100. So after simplification, we can cancel it. 5 1 5, 5 2 10, 0. 5 4 20, and 5 5 25. Again we can cancel. 5 4 20, 5 9 45. The answer becomes x equal to 9/4. Means what is the x? 2.25. means 2.25 we can write in the form of 9/4. Means this is your decimal form and this is your fraction form. So let I'm giving you some questions. 3.752 first, second 47.15, third one is 125.450, and the fourth one is 0.725. so this is your homework. So today we complete four topics. Check whether the given number are rational or irrational. First, the second one is a rational number as a division of integer. Third one is observing the decimal expansion of rational numbers. The fourth one is converting a terminating decimal into fraction form. Okay.